Ready to go all the way, boys?
Yeah!
Ready to go all the fucking way!
Yeah! Alright, ready to shoot. Big team on three. Okay, one, two, three.
Team! Hey, guys, listen. Stay in here. Listen, this is why we do the drills. That's why you put in the hard work of practice. Because a situation like that comes up when the stupid team puts four on the board and we kill them up the middle. We have plays now, guys. We had one match to get ready.
Bread and butter.
This is just where we're starting, boys. This is just the beginning.
Alright,
let's go, boys.
Are you?
Oh, yeah!
Are you?
Oh, yeah!
Are you?
Oh, yeah!
Are you?
Oh, yeah!
Are you?
Woo! Let's go, boys. Good job.
My name is Dave Pando. I am 23 years old. I'm a super senior, and I've been playing paintball for about 10, 11 years now.
I'm Joe Meenan. I'm 24. I am a fifth year senior, and I've been playing 12 years now? 12 years.
My name is Alexander Marcomario. I am a junior, about to be a senior. I have been playing for 8 or 9 years.
All right, my name is Doug Setterholm. I'm a junior right now. I'm about to be a senior. I've been playing for about 6 or 7 years.
Oh, man, the tryouts before nationals, everybody played nasty. That was ridiculous. Everybody showed up and was doing their job, having fun. You know, everything it should be. Nobody was getting upset or anything like that. We were just there to, you know, play. And I think that's what helped everyone play as well as they did.
The trials before nationals this year were the best that I've ever seen. You know, I've been around for 5 of them, and this year was the hardest to make the cuts. There was the most people trying out, the most people that actually were good trying out, and so yeah, seeing a really good tryout is something, you know, that I was actually proud of.
Playing-wise, I think we all did pretty well, but for the paint, it didn't really make us look that good.
Guns were blowing paint up.
It was raining really hard, and it was like 40 degrees outside. So instead of focusing on your game, you're struggling just to get your gun working or to find a working gun. It was very chaotic. We were just kind of going out there. We weren't organized at all. So here we go again, another time, but it feels the same.
Survivors left to see. Too late for the. When I was running down the last guy, I shot him out and he still came out shooting at me. So I just kind of kept shooting at him as he shot at me. And someone from the pits yelled that, that's a penalty, that's a penalty.
There was some discrepancy with the reffing. You know, we're kind of the visiting team, so to speak, playing in Pittsburgh with 2 Pennsylvania teams in our conference. We lost, you know, 1 too many matches. I think we went 1-3 when we should have went 3-1.
That last event was just a big old clusterfuck.
The next weekend we got back. We had a 2-day practice. We drilled all day Saturday, and everyone put a lot of effort into it. And same with the next day.
We all got really focused on getting better, and we realized that we had some holes that we needed to work on, and it motivated us to buckle down and really prepare for nationals. Traveling to all the events with, you know, the OU team is probably the best part about it.
Everybody's either hungover or just tired and doesn't want to go to the airport. 25, 30 people going to an event together all on the same flight like we did. Things just kind of pile on top of each other and get funny.
I opt to drive to nationals every year because It's a road trip, is what it is, and that's why I like it. There's so many things, so many goofy, ridiculous things. It's hard to even recall them specifically. You know, I like that I can always say I remember driving to Nationals. I was laughing most of the time.
Let's fucking win this, man. Let's bring a fucking title. Think about how cool it would be to bring, to say that our school, OU, is the best paintball college in the country. Like, and that you were a part of that. Isn't that what we all want? Isn't that the fucking coolest thing you could ever, like, bring home to OU? We did awesome in the prelims and nationals. I mean, we were smoking every team that we played.
Guys, the four is watching the snake. When you get in the snake, Brooklyn, Panda, whoever gets in the snake, go. When I sell green, go, 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 and just have your gun. Make sure you watch it, because what they do is the two comes around.
Having Robbie as our coach was a huge asset to us.
He tells you what you're doing wrong, but he's not like a jerk about it. You know, you're doing this wrong, he tells you, and you're like, all right, I just got to change it.
And he's really good at putting people in the places that they should be so that they can be most effective on the field.
You have to have that in order to win. I mean, it really showed on Friday.
That was, I think, a testament to how good our team actually was this year, because not only were we stomping the teams that we were supposed to stomp, and the teams that were going to be tough that we were going to have to really grind against, we proved that we could beat, you know, we could beat any team there pretty much.
But in the end, it's just a sport. It's a big part of our life, but it's just a sport that we love. It's about shooting your teammate in the back of the head by accident during a close game, then him giving you crap about it later on that night.
He goes, I was shooting S3. I was fucking shooting S3, waiting for the pop-up. Guy popped up, shot him. Then I see Pando get
up. Or it's about pulling the greatest prank on your teammate after you guys get knocked out of the tournament.
Shut the fuck up.
And call it.
I bet you they don't pick up.
Hello?
Or maybe even just challenging your coach to a fight that you have no chance in this world of winning.
I think he's trying to make me feel confident. that was on the back.
It's about the memories that you make with your teammates that you have to look back on in your life. Winning and losing is just a part of it, but the memories will be there both when you win and lose. And that's what paintball is all about.
Yeah. Feel that.
I mean, a couple of years ago, we didn't have...
Brooklyn. Hey, why don't you do something there, Brooklyn? Always getting out of work because you think filming is an excuse. Fucking bullshit.
Documentary first.
I won't forget!
Cookie butt!
Cookie butt!
Cookie butt!
Look at all the hay on it.
It's ridiculous!
Gertie has won it.
Oh, the man!
That's right!
Made a quick purchase.
What up?
How you doing?
Oh, Batista.
Yeah, I'm fine here.
You dick.